Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, Study Money. And in today's topic, we'll talk about emergency fund. Okay, so this is a series of videos that will particularly talk about having an emergency fund, what an emergency fund is for, the basics of budgeting, and all that good stuff. So if you would like to know more about all the fundamentals of having an emergency fund, stay tuned and watch this video. Okay. So, bagong tabas tayo ngayon. Kinig kayo sa akin, ha? Bagong ahit ako ngayon. So, guys, okay, we will talk about the emergency fund. And this is part one. And to start off, okay, what is an emergency fund? Ano nga ba ang emergency fund? Para saan to? Para saan to ginagamit? Okay? So, basically, an emergency fund is the amount of resources, or speaking financially, the amount of money that you have saved up for so-called emergencies. So, emergencies are never really planned. Okay? So, hindi mo naman paplanuhin na maaksidente, di ba? Hindi ka naman siguro ganun ka-weird. Hindi mo paplanuhin na magkasakit, di ba? Hindi mo paplanuhin na masira yung sasakyan mo. Lahat ng taong normal mag-isip, ayaw yun. Pero lahat din ng normal na tao, dapat meron nito. You understand? Okay? Each and every person must have an emergency fund. Okay? For things that are, and God forbid, happens to each and any one of us. Okay? Let's talk about various types of emergencies. So, car breakdown or car repair. Alright? Hindi biro magpaayos ng sasakyan. So, mag-overheat yung sasakyan mo, kailangan i-overhaul. Man, I'm telling you, that's expensive. Okay? Magkasakit ka, and God forbid, it happens. Okay? That is expensive. Being rushed in the emergency room alone will cost you a lot of money. It has happened to me. Okay? I guess 5 months ago, I was rushed in the ER for a severe headache, for a very bad migraine, okay? And, you know, oddly enough, just for a migraine, for a headache, all the pain meds and all the good, you know, all the things that they've done to me, it amounted to close to 15,000 pesos, okay? ER lang yun, 15,000. How much more, okay, if you will need to go through surgery, and again, God forbid it happens to you, but what do you do when you have that situation? Next type of emergency, okay? Unplanned travels. So, anong ibig sabihin ng unplanned traveling? Let's just suppose, okay, that a member of the family has passed away or a member of the family falls ill. And again, God forbid, it happens to any one of our family members, but it happens, di ba? Wala tayong magagawa kung nandiyan na yung sitwasyon na yan. So, what do you do? Mangungutang ka ba? Ha? Syempre hindi, di ba? You have to have an emergency fund. These are just, you know, hypothetical scenarios, but these are scenarios that happen regularly. These happen every day. So, my question to you is, are you prepared for that? Gaano ka kahanda for these kinds of emergencies? Okay? Now, secondly, when should you start to have or build your emergency fund? Okay? So, kung nagtatrabaho ka na, or kahit hindi ka nagtatrabaho, nagdenegosyo ka, may sideline ka, you're a working student, okay? Start building your emergency fund right now. Ngayon na! Labas ka na ng bahay! Nabiro lang. Nag ka muna. Okay? So, you know, build your emergency fund right now, okay? What, you know, take a portion of whatever you earn and put it in a safe place. Of course, I would advise a bank, Okay, parang hindi mo nagagalaw. But for some reason that it's not yet enough, okay, to be put in the bank, then siguro keep a cash stash that you're the only person who knows about it. All right, then eventually move that money into an institution, a place safer, you know, a place that no one else could touch. And we'll talk about that even more in the succeeding videos. All right, so again, start saving up for an emergency fund right now. Sa susunod na sweldo mo, bawasan mo na. Pay yourself first. And we'll talk about paying yourself first more in the next coming videos. Alright? Now, next is, who needs an emergency fund? Well, if you're working, alright, obviously, I'm talking to you. Yeah, ikaw. Nagtatrabaho ka, kumikita ka, start building your emergency fund. Kung 16 years old ka, pataas, start building your emergency fund. Kumikita ka na ng pera, be responsible enough to handle yourself, or at least have a little bit of amount of financial resources saved up, okay, to at least prepare for these things, okay? Kunyari, nagbabasketball ka, napilayan ka, okay? And wala si mami, wala si daddy, iyak-iyak ka na, di ba? So paano yan? How will you be able to at least address that simple situation? Ano, maghihintay ka pa dumating yung motor ng Bombay bukas? Ha? Para magkaroon ka ng pambayad sa ospital? Obviously not, di ba? You must have that emergency fund in place already. Ulit-ulitin ko to, ha? Ipupukpuk ko na ipupukpuk sa ulo mo to. Kaya makinig ka mabuti. Okay? Next is, I guess this is one of the reasons, okay? Why do we need to have an emergency fund? This is one of the major reasons for this video. The why, okay? Bakit kailangan mo ng emergency fund? Okay, granting, emergencies happen. But again, these are unplanned, okay? Walang nagpaplano na maaksidente siya. Unless, of course, you have an ulterior motive, o siguro medyo may sayad ka, nagpaplanuhin mo yun. But if you're a normal thinking person, just like you and I, okay, you will always have to understand that emergencies happen. Okay? And next is, if emergencies do occur, all right, if you have the emergency fund, you can prevent yourself from going into debt. Okay, hindi ibig sabihin mamamatay ka. Ang ibig sabihin nun, hindi ka mababaon sa utang. Okay? Hindi ka mangungutang kapag may emergency. Okay? So, if, again, you will need to travel from one place to the next, siguro, just like the situation that we have right now with this coronavirus pandemic, okay, people are traveling from one place to the next. Okay, they're swiping their cards. Ah, kaskas dito, kaskas dyan, di ba? Banat na banat. So, bilin ng ticket. And again, why would you have to go into debt kung meron kang nakahanda para sa mga ganyang klaseng situation? I want you to seriously think about it. Okay? Never go into debt unless, again, it's for, you know, a much better reason. And that's reserved for a different topic. But right now, as far as emergencies go, okay, prevent yourself from going into debt. And this is why you need to have an emergency fund. Alright? Next is, kung meron kang emergency fund, you have this peace of mind. Okay? You can sleep soundly at night knowing that you have a plan B. Meron kang fallback. Okay? So, many people nowadays, with this pandemic going on, are panic buying. Okay? Again, siguro marami sa kanila, niratrat yung credit card nila. Kaskas dito, kaskas dyan, di ba? But, if you have your emergency fund, you can at least minimize the panic and just buy with a little bit of peace of mind while you make these purchases. Okay? So, it helps. You know, it prevents the panic. And somehow, some way, it gives you a cushion. It has a fall. You have a fallback kung sakaling mangyari yung bagay na yun. Yung mga emergencies kagaya ngayon. Okay? Now, last that we'll talk about in this video is how much should you have saved up for an emergency fund? Okay? So, I urge everybody to at least save up 30,000 pesos as fast as you can. Okay? Kung meron ka ng lump sum dyan sa savings mo, get it out of that account, put it in a different bank, and that's your emergency fund. Ngayon, hindi yun natatapos dun, okay? The 30,000 pesos is just your first line of defense. But typically, okay, you will need to have saved up for 6 months to 1 year of living expenses. Again, 6 months to 1 year of living expenses. Bakit kamo? Okay? So, ngayon, sa sitwasyon ngayon, alright, people have stopped working and syempre, no work, no pay, di ba? So, alam naman bayaran kanila, hindi yung tatrabaho. Ano yung lokohan? Di ba? So, again, God forbid, job loss happens to you or to someone else. And again, I hope that this does not happen, but it happens. May mga nalilay off, okay? And so, how will you solve that kind of situation? How will you survive the daily things that you will need to spend on? Okay? Upa or mortgage. Pagkain. Okay? Kuryente. Tubig. And creature comforts. If sanay ka sa ganung klaseng way of life. How? Kung wala kang emergency fund, paano yun? Paano kung isang kahig, isang tuka ka lang, di ba? Ang mangyayari sa'yo niyan, mga buitre, tutukain ka sa mata. Mamamatay ka ng dilat. Nebiro lang yun. Okay? I know that it's too morbid. But again, I want you to take this very seriously. Okay? Have an emergency fund in place. It's important. I cannot repeat myself many times over this. And again, this video is dedicated to all my countrymen who are ill-prepared for these kinds of emergencies. I hope that you start thinking about this very seriously. Kasi kung wala ka nito, alright, baka mahirapan ka mag-cope up in the eventual days, weeks, months that would come if you do not have this as your safety net. Okay? So, in the next video, we will talk about how to build your emergency fund. So, I hope that you like this video and follow part 2. So, if you have any questions, comments, suggestions, or anything that you have in mind, write it down in the comment section below. And if you have not already, hit the subscribe button, smash that bell, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.